Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. This week I had a request to make an important part for John's model engine. It's made from a piece of aluminium 15mm thick with a 3mm stud machined on the back. So John, you can come with me into the workshop and see how I made the component you need.
I've taken this piece of aluminium which I've cut out on the bandsaw. I've drawn a cross between the two corners diagonally to mark the centre, and to line it up in the chuck I've just got my scriber point into the chuck in the tailstock, like pull it in like that, and then adjust the jaws of the chuck to get it roughly on centre. I've moved the tool up to the face and just checked that I'm touching on both sides so I know it's fairly flat, and I've locked it up at that. So what I'm going to do is machine a 3mm stud in the middle of this, and I'm going to come back about 10mm on this to give me the stud. In aluminium, the one thing to look out for is on the tip of the tool you don't get a piece of aluminium building up, as it tends to stick to the tool. Every now and again I spray it with a bit of WD-40 to make sure it keeps clear. Let's check how far I am away from the chuck jaws. I'm not going to risk going any closer than that. So what I want to do now is just put a bit of WD-40 on the tip, see if I can get a nice finish. Too bad. Now I'm going to go on to the centre part, turn the diameter down to 3mm. Four at the moment. Three and a half. Here's my micrometer on this. A better reading. 0.135. I need 0.118.
0.125.
So I'll leave that at that. I'll put a lead on because I need to put the thread on this. Put a thread on that of 3mm. So tidy up. I've put a 3mm die in my die holder. I've got the handle on the rear of the headstock so I can turn by hand. And I'll just feed this in. Just pushing the end of the tailstock by hand, feeding it in. Might have a problem that the die holder will hit the jaws. Just take the bolt off the die holder. It's still held by two grub screws. That's a 3mm thread by 0.5mm pitch. And that's finished on that side. So the next job is to take it out the chuck, turn it round, and machine the other side. So what I've done now is I've taken the chuck off. I've put this number 3 Morse taper to an ER20 collet. I've put in a 3mm collet and locked the aluminium plate up on that. Now the only thing I'm worried about, if I take too big a cut off, it will probably just shear off the piece of aluminium. So I'll try and do this gently. is just touch the centre with the revolving centre, just to see if I can give it some support. Might do it. Yeah, as you can see, it's been the finish on that. You can see it's vibrating. I'm expecting a lot, but at least it's vibrating all over the surface, so I know the surface is true to the front. And I'll be machining this off anyway.
We'll now machine the front part on the CNC machine with the 3mm peg going into the backing board. Can you guess where it is yet? That's it, one eagle finished for the front of a model engine. That's it for today, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.